in my YouTube channel Tech Knowledge. Today in this session, we will discuss about the translator. Let's get started. What do you mean by translator? Translator, nothing but it is used for converting one form to another form. In English, there is a translator, means convert or translate Hindi to English, translate English to Hindi, means you have to convert one language to another language. This is known as translator. This translator is also used in terms of computer, because our computer understand only machine code, machine language, that is called low level language. But human can understand only high level code, high level language. So for this, to convert high level language to low level or low level language to high level, we need some translators. Translator is a program that is used to convert one language to another language. In real life example, you have seen when one Indian person goes to America or somewhere else like Japan or China, whatever, he or she requires translator. Translator means if Indian person want to ask something from Japanese person, Indian person speak in his or her mother tongue, then Chinese or Japanese person cannot understand it. So what they will do? Either they can communicate in English because it is international language, or second one, he or she requires translator. Means Indian language convert into Chinese or Japanese language, and then Japanese or Chinese person can understand. Similarly, if Japanese or Chinese person want to say something to the Indian person, then again here translator is required. So translator plays very important role. The program, especially, see the definition, the program especially designed to convert the instruction written in computer language. In computer language means high level language, assembly language, all comes under computer language, into machine language, so that it is executed by CPU directly. Means CPU can execute only machine language, which is written in low level. It is called translator. The instruction that needs to be translated is called source code. Means a program which is written by the programmer is called source code. And the instruction after converting into machine language, means once it is converted with the help of translator, it makes another file. That file is called object code. Means source code is a original file which is written by programmer, and after processing, after translating, whatever we get in the machine language is called object code. So there are the following types of translators available in a computer. First is assembler, second is compiler, and third one is interpreter. These are the three translators available. Assembler. Assembler is a translator which requires to convert your assembly language program to the machine language. Requires to convert assembly language. Assembly language used mnemonics, means abbreviation of the word it used. So means when we convert our assembly language code to machine language, that time a program is required. That program is called assembler. So assembler is a translator. Then compiler. Compiler is a special program designed to convert high level programming code to the machine language or object code, so the computer can understand it. Similarly, interpreter is also a program which convert high level code to the machine language, which computer can understand it. So what is the difference between compiler and interpreter? Both works like same, Both is used for converting high level language to the machine code. What is the actual difference behind that? Compiler. Compiler transforms the entire program and generate an executable program so that is stored in the computer's memory and used whenever it is required. Means the actual definition of compiler is, compiler is a program, it is a translator that convert your high level code to machine language at one go. Means it convert whole program at the same time. Whereas interpreter is a program that convert high level code to the low level code by line, mean one line at a time. Interpreter convert one line at a time, whereas compiler convert whole program at the same time. Is it clear? So these two are used for converting high language to the low level language. Now, this point you keep in your mind. Java language has both compiler and interpreter. The source code converted into bytecode by compiler, then bytecode is translated by interpreter into a machine dependent language. This is the most important point. This point you have to keep in your own mind. Now, this topic is clear to you. I hope you understand this topic. What do you mean by compiler, assembler, or interpreter? These many types of translators. Thank you, class.